Welcome back to the workshop. I'm just getting the fire going. It's getting warm in here, and I have to make a video today that I really did not want to make. You guys ever like a product, but at some point they failed you with their, I don't know, next product or subsequent product? Well, today this is what this is all about. Now, a couple years ago, I did a similar, it was like a review of the Kujo work shoes that I bought, okay? And they were my black ones. And if you go back to that video, and I'll probably put it right here somewhere so you guys can see it, I love those shoes, right? They were comfortable, they were great, they kept my feet dry out in the landscape and in the yards and all that. They wore very well, awesome. They, you know what, here's the thing, you guys. Those last ones that I had, those black Kujos, lasted me 2 years. 2 years, so I encourage you to watch that video. There might be, you know, like a revision of them. I can't remember what I did there, but those things lasted me 2 years before they eventually just wore out to a point where I was getting dirt and things in there. So last year, 2023, the spring, I figured, you know what, I'm gonna buy another pair of Kujos because those were, my first ones were so great, the black ones. So I opted for this color, and I didn't really want to choose this color because I figured it's gonna get dirty really quick because it's a brighter color. I don't know what they call this, the green or whatever. But they end up looking similar to the black ones. They're all gonna look the same. You walk these things through grass every week, everything just looks dirty, the same dirty, okay? Just a little bit brighter than the black ones. But typically, they're the same thing, you know, as far as the way they look dirty. This whole front piece right here. So let me tell you what is disappointing with these new Kujos that I got last year. The worst thing about these shoes that are different than the original black ones that I had, these ones lasted me probably, well, from spring cleanup in the spring, April, through the fall cleanups, which is November. Then I noticed my feet were getting wet. Now, keep in mind, the black ones that I had before these, they lasted me two full seasons without tearing or ripping or anything. So let me tell you, the first thing that I started noticing was this right here. You see how this is pulling away? This glue? I've never had that with the black ones. The black ones never pulled away. That glue always held. Okay, so I've got a gap there. So I noticed the side of my toes, my feet were getting wet every morning, which is the reason why you want to buy these shoes, so you keep your feet nice and dry all day, right? Who wants wet feet? Nobody. So that was the first thing that was happening, and that was late summer and that was happening. Well, got into the fall cleanups, weather got a little bit colder, we're pushing, you know, heavy things around, blowers, pushing leaves, picking up things, and then this inside part of the shoe, it just blew out one day. You see that? Look at that. It just let loose. So now both sides of my feet are wet every day of this shoe. So I'm gonna do this little movement right here. You see that? Okay, my black ones never did this, you guys. They never did this. And I'll tell you what, even this front, it feels a little different. I don't know. Those black ones seem like they were better rubber. I don't know. Maybe the good folks at Kujo will know. But I had the worst issue with these things. And I'm telling you guys, it didn't even get through a full season. Okay, what happened? Because your first Kujos that I had, those black ones, 2 years, two seasons, you guys. Now, I put them up in the winter. I don't use these in the winter because they're not snow shoes, right? Obviously. So I wear them from spring cleanup to fall cleanup. And then I put them in the garage. Another thing that I didn't like, this part right here, this little breather part, which I think is a nice little genius. It's a good touch, okay? I like it. But from the walking, the flexing on both of them, and this one's even worse, that is just worn out. Now, this is supposed to be a breather because, you know, basically this whole shoe is a breather shoe, which I love it, up to, you know, a certain point because it's waterproof down below. but it breathes. It's very breathable, and that's one good thing that I like about the shoe. But this wore out, and my black ones, they didn't wear out like this. Now listen, I'm doing the same jobs, the same customers every week. All right, this one right here is a little worse, you guys. You see how this one has all of this in that wear spot, okay? It's even worse. So now, okay, so this shoe started to rip on the other side. This side, the glue held together. This is my left shoe, see, left foot. This, the glue held together there. But over here on the outside, towards the fall, or you know, during fall cleanups, this left side of the shoe ripped and tore out. So, again, my black ones never did this. Same shoe, just in black, a couple years older, never did this. Let me tell you the parts that I do like. They're comfortable, they fit right, they fit me properly, okay? They seem like they fit, hold on. They seem to fit well, okay? They seem to, for my size, I think these are 9s or 10s. These are 9s, American 9s. So these fit me very well, okay? I know some guys in the past have talked about these things being too narrow, whatever. I had no issue with that. Comfortable, yes, very, very comfortable. They don't, my feet never hurt in these shoes, right? They never once hurt. I really like that. The soles seem to last. These ones are wore down a little, but that's not bad. I've got work boots that wore down worse than this. So the soles are good, you guys. The Kujo soles are great. The insides of the shoes are great. They're comfortable. They come with this nice, look, I still have a little bit of grass in there. Nice padding. And my feet, my knees, my ankles, nothing ever hurt with these on. My biggest complaint though, you guys, brothers and sisters out there in the same field, okay, and you guys do this and you wear these, have you noticed a difference between the older Kujo and these ones? These are the 2023 models. Blown out on the inside there and on the outside on my left one. Again, same properties. I've been serving the same customers for some of them 30 years, okay? Again, I can put these on right now and they're still comfortable. These would be great now just to wear around the shop where I'm not gonna be in any dirt, any mud or anything, because now what happened, not only am I getting wet in these, but my socks were getting filthy inside here, which never happened before until these sides ripped out. So you know, even every time you take a step, you get that dust. The shoelaces, awesome shoelaces. They've never, even in my black ones, 2 years old, I've never had to do anything with them. I never had to replace them, never washed these. These are the originals, the black ones that came with it. The tongues are great, the nice padding in there. I had no issues with that. They're all comfortable inside. The only issue is the rubber, cement, and the peeling away. I don't know. I don't know what happened. Kujo, what is this, Kujo? What, I don't know. Nothing I did any different for the last 2 years than I did with my black pair prior to these. So again, I don't like to make these, and I'm not bad mouthing Kujo. I'm asking questions because we're here at the start of 2024 and we're up here in Michigan and we're about to get busy, and I don't have a pair of shoes right now to wear, or boots. I can't go back in the field with these. I can't. The first 10 minutes trying to do you know, some weed whipping or whatever, my feet will be soaked the rest of the day. I can't do it. Maybe I'll save these for in here, right in the shop. Who knows? This color looks good when it's new, but after a week, they don't look good anymore. Actually, the black ones look the best, even when they're dirty, because you really can't tell. But these ones are like trying to be clean, even though they're dirty, where the black ones are just got dirty. I don't know, you guys. Just, if you guys have any suggestions, if you guys know of anything that you've heard of, maybe that I am overlooking, I never put anything on these. I don't think you have to. I thought these were rubber. But my black ones just never acted this strange. I don't know what happened at the facility at Kujo within the last couple years. I don't know. If you guys have any comments, or you can help me out as to what to do. I don't know. Should I buy another pair of Kujos? Well, if they're going to be like this, no. But if they were going to be like my old Kujos, those old black ones, yes. But if I'm expecting this now, I'm going to have to go back to something else. Because these, by far, were the best shoes out there that I could use for lawn maintenance. Boots, as all you guys know, the boots for lawn maintenance are not good. Tennis shoes, not good. These were the best thing that I've had in years. The original Kujos, okay? So, but now, again, I don't know. So I'm just asking you guys for help. What do you guys know? What have you learned about the Kujos as of late? And if you don't recommend these, what do you recommend? I need something that's low. I don't want the high stuff coming up. You know, talking about summertime. We're talking 90s right here. I need something low. I don't want the high stuff. We're not landscaping. We're not pushing shovels. We're not doing any of that stuff. So these are just dedicated only to lawn maintenance. So got to have, it's got to be waterproof. Those mornings, you guys, you know how it is. Sometimes you get those sprinklers out there that people run. And you want your feet to be dry. That's my biggest complaint. I want my feet to be dry and stay clean. These broke down very, very fast. Was it a materials change that they did? I don't know. So that's why I'm reaching out to you guys. Hopefully somebody out there knows. If you guys have any input on what I could do here with these Kujos, as far as purchasing next, you guys have anything that you like? Please let me know. And I want to check the comments. So again, thank you guys. If you guys know Kujo or whatever, if anybody out there from Kujo knows, help me out. Again, I really like these shoes, but not this pair. I don't know what happened. Okay, so I don't know what happened in the manufacturing. Like I said, if something's changed or whatever, but yeah, Kujo shoes, you guys. Work shoes, yard shoes. Thanks for watching. The season's on us, and I hope you guys have a lot of work to do out there this year, and hopefully you get all the help you can if you guys are looking to build a crew. So as for me, it's just me anymore, but I want to be comfortable, and I want to be fast and efficient, and right now these are not. So I'm Jesse James, and if you can't stay safe, then stay dangerous.